Praise the Lord, everyone. We welcome you today, this morning, for our English service. We have a special song today for worship, the blessing. Moses told to Aaron that you will bless the children of Israel in this wise. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance and give you peace. So we welcome you to join with us as we sing and worship this song. The Lord bless you and keep you, make his face shine upon you, be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Weeping and rejoicing, he's for you, he's for you.
Yes, Lord Jesus. We thank you for your grace that is upon us, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that your glory has risen upon us. We thank you for the light of the face, O Lord, that is shining upon us, Lord. We thank you for your blessing, O Father, that is breaking every curse, O Lord. We thank you, Jesus, for your presence that is going with us. We thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. What a joy it is this morning to come into the presence of God and to worship our God. Hallelujah. He is awesome. And His presence brings healing and deliverance and freedom. And this morning, I believe you have experienced that freedom even through this worship. Today, the title of my message is, Have I Understood the Heart of Christ? Amen. Many a times in our lives, we have to ask this question to ourselves deliberately. Have I understood the heart of Christ? Because to us in this fast-paced world, everything is moving. Everything is going fast. And in the midst of that, there are chaos, there is worries, there is sadness, there is pain, there is sickness. And through it all, have I understood the heart of Christ? What He feels for us, how He yearns for us. Have we understood that? Because today we're going to look at the story of the man who was healed at the pool of Bethesda. John chapter 5, verse 1 to 15.
Afterwards, Jesus returned to Jerusalem for one of the Jewish holidays. Inside the city near the Sheep Gate was a pool of Bethesda, with five covered porches. Crowds of sick people, blind, lame or paralyzed, lay on the porches. One of the men lying there had been sick for 38 years. When Jesus saw him and knew how long he had been ill, he asked him, Would you like to get well? I can't, sir, the sick man said, for I have no help, no one to help me into the pool when the water is stirred up. While I am trying to get there, someone else always gets in ahead of me. Jesus told him, Stand up, pick up your sleeping mat and walk. Instantly the man was healed. He rolled up the mat and began walking. But this miracle happened on the Sabbath day. So the Jewish leaders objected. They said to the man who was cured, You can't work on the Sabbath. It's illegal to carry the sleeping mat. He replied, The man who healed me said to me, Pick up your sleeping mat and walk. Who said such a thing as that? They demanded. The man didn't know, for Jesus had disappeared into the crowd. But afterward, Jesus found him in the temple and told him, Now you are well, so stop sinning, or something even worse may happen to you. Then the man went to the Jewish leaders and told them it was Jesus who had healed him.
Amen. Hallelujah. So this story in the Bible is a very important story, because this truly proves to us our character, our feelings, and the way we behave, and the heart of Christ. Jesus is having sympathy upon this person. He has a heart for this person. He is yearning for this person who has been sick for 38 years. It's been long time that he has been at that pool waiting for his chance for a miracle. And like him, thousands and millions of people around the world is today waiting for some miracle or the other in their lives. And I believe even as you are listening to this message, you are also waiting for some miracles to happen, for relationship miracles, for business miracles, for job miracles, for my future miracle, for the healing miracle. We are all waiting for miracles to happen in our lives. But the problem with us is our attitude, our character, and the way we approach The throne room of God, the mercy seat of God is all that is hindering our miracle. Why for 38 long years he was not healed? Because his character and his attitude towards the things of the Lord was very negative and wrong. Dear people of God, today as I am speaking this message to you, please open your heart, open your mind and take in where I need to correct myself, because Jesus is willing to heal you. Here is Jesus. This man doesn't deserve that healing, but still Jesus is reaching out and healing him. But then there is also a warning that Jesus gives him. And that warning is, do not sin, because if you sin, something worse will come upon you. So we need to be very careful. Jesus is coming to us. He is reaching out to us. He is yearning for us. He loves us dearly and he wants to do a miracle right now in your life. So through the story, here is Jesus on the Sabbath day healing this man who was paralyzed for 38 years. I mean, paralyzed is without movement. His whole body was freezed. He couldn't move. He couldn't do anything by himself. But Jesus approaches him and asks him a question. Do you want to be healed, or do you want to become well? Today, Jesus is asking you, my people, his beloved children, he's asking, do you want to be well? Do you want to be healed? What should our reply be? What should our approach be? Do we understand the love of Christ? Because if we know the person that is asking us is the Son of God, is the one that brings salvation into the world, we will surely approach him with more reverence, with more love. But here is this paralytic man. The reason for him to be in that place for 38 years is this. His reply was, there is no one to help me put me into this pool when the water is stirred. So he is having self-sympathy to himself. He is complaining at this moment. Instead of asking Jesus that, yes, I want to be healed. You have approached me and my reply should be, Lord, I want to be healed. Today, just say, Lord, I want to be healed. Don't tell him why you are in this situation. He doesn't want to know who did this to you. He doesn't want to know that you have been hurting for such a long time. He just is asking us, do you want to be well? Whatever your hurting situation, whoever did this evil against you, whoever put you in that state, whatever is brought that sickness upon you today, don't bother it. Because Jesus doesn't want to know what the history of it was, what the past situation was, what your past life was. He doesn't want to know that. He just wants to heal you. Today, beloved people of God, just come. Approach the throne room of God, the mercy seat of God that is healing today. Just approach him. Don't complain. Don't nag. Don't judge. Don't doubt today of what God can do for you. Here is this man. Completely wrong statement. Jesus is asking, do you want to be well? And he says, there is no one to help me. Rather, he should have said, yes, Lord, I want to be healed. Today, beloved people, just say, yes, Lord, I want to be healed. And I believe instantly there will be healing in your body. And I release this word. that Jesus is healing you right now. Wherever you are, whatever your situation, you may be hurting today, you may be in emotional pain today, you may be physically in pain today, you may be sick today, Jesus is healing you. Receive that healing right now. Do not complain. Do not put that situation over anybody, but rather just receive what the Lord is giving you. And then through this story, we're going to see his character and attitude, this man's character and attitude. He was arrogant and prideful. He had the complaining spirit, arguing spirit. And finally, he was so restless and so unthankful. So the first thing that we notice is he did not give thanks for his healing. He never came back to Jesus. He never found out who it was. And he didn't even have the gratitude of going after Jesus. Because when you look at the other healings, we see that they fell at the feet of Jesus, or they spoke to him that, Jesus, we want to follow you, or they embraced him, and there was different reactions. But here is this man who got healed after 38 years. He just walked. He just picked up his bed and he walked. Because Jesus commanded him, he just did what he was supposed to do. Be thankful for the miracle that God is doing in your life. These kind of attitude does not help us recognize the hand of God in our lives, or even understand the love of Christ in our lives. Therefore, we should stop complaining. Because a thankful heart will never complain. But unthankful heart will always complain. Are we thankful for what the Lord has done in our lives? If we are thankful, then we will have no complaints. So in every situation, whether bad or good, whether in sickness, whether in life, whatever you are going through, be thankful. Be thankful for the season. Be thankful for the for your family, for the people around, for your enemies. Be thankful for everything. Then you will never complain. But if we are not thankful, we will surely be complaining. Secondly, couldn't take correction. This man couldn't take correction. The moment Jesus approached him and searched him, in fact, Jesus went out, found him, and told him to not sin. Because if you sin, something worse may come upon you. So Jesus knew his heart, that he was not true to himself. He was not true to God. That is why Jesus had to approach him again and remind him or correct him that do not sin. Did he take it? No. He immediately went, because just before this, the Pharisees asked, who asked you to pick up your bed and walk on a Sabbath day? He said, I don't know who the person was. But now when he came to know, he immediately went and complained about him, that it was Jesus. And from there on, the Bible says, the Pharisees were even more after Jesus to kill him. So, we see such kind of people all around us who never have that attitude, the right attitude, and they can never take correction. So, but if we allow the Holy Spirit to work in us, He will take us deep into the Word of God and open our eyes. The Holy Spirit will speak to us through the Word, and our eyes will be opened. So allow the Holy Spirit to work. First, be thankful for whatever situation, we will not complain. Secondly, allow the Holy Spirit to work in us, allow the Word to speak to us, then we will be able to take the corrections. Thirdly, spirit of entitlement. That I deserved it. I've waited 38 years. I've struggled. I've gone through pain. So this is my right. I should get this healing. This is for me. I prayed for it. And why should I be thankful for it? Because God had to do this for me. There is an entitlement here. He wanted to tell that I deserved it. Many a times we receive things, we receive miracles, we receive the grace of God, we escape death, we receive His miracles, but then we take it as an entitlement that I deserved it, that I am a holy person, that there is nobody like me, I am better than my neighbor, I am better than that person. I do not speak evil. So we try to prove ourselves that we deserved it. Let me remind you, dear people of God, grace is undeserved. We didn't deserve it. But still, God, in His mercy and love, He gave. Amen. So we cannot entitle ourselves for it, but rather it is God in His love and mercy and grace that He wants to give it to us. Jesus approached this man and He said, "Do you want to be healed?" So Jesus wanted to give it to him, but he wanted to receive it as his title, that I deserve it. A terrible mistake. I'm telling you, we all, somewhere or the other, we keep making mistakes like these small ones, but then end up completely miserable. So that is why today the Word of God is speaking to us and reminding us that we need to correct and mend our lives, and we need to understand the heart of Christ, because the heart of Christ yearns for us. He loves us. So, beloved people, don't complain and be thankful for every situation, and don't entitle yourself for the things of the Lord. It is by grace that we have received this life. Live it to the fullest and enjoy every moment. Amen. So, the things that we need to mend. The first thing, if you're writing down, please make these points. We need to read and meditate on the Word of God. If we want to understand the heart of God, then the first thing we need to do is we need to read and meditate on the Word of God. Be filled in the Holy Spirit. Second, be filled in the Holy Spirit. Third, be humble. Fourth, be teachable and open for correction. Fifth, be thankful what you have instead of grumbling over what you don't have. Be thankful for what you have and don't grumble over the things that you don't have. And never compare yourself with somebody else, because God made you unique. We need to move into that change. We need to understand the heart of God. He yearns for us. Amen. So today, my beloved people, if you have understood the heart of God, I believe that miracle is right there for you, and you will receive a new life, and the Holy Spirit will guide us. God bless you. Father, I thank you, Lord, for this word, and I believe that this word will be refreshing to our bones, to our soul, to our spirit, and Lord, that we will be renewed in mind and spirit, of God. Lord, that we may serve you faithfully and not, Lord, be people who entitle ourselves for things that is from heaven, O God. But rather, we will be thankful and we will not complain. And Lord, we will give you all the glory and honor and praise, because you deserve it. I bless the people today, O God, that are listening to your word. I believe for their miracle. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. May the love of the Father, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the sweet fellowship and communion of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with each one of us now and forevermore. And all God's people said, Amen and Amen and Amen. God bless you.